The goal of this project is to capture the knowledge and experiences of change leaders to help inform other departments and colleges in transforming their STEM programs. We interviewed 8 individuals from institutions across the country. We asked them to share advice on how to build buy-in. This is what they had to say.
I think a huge shout out goes to staff here, because most of our initiatives in the last 10 years were spearheaded by staff advisors, services advisors, academic advisors, directors of student services. They are the ones who really, and at the time I was staff before I moved to the faculty side, they saw the need because they were advising the students. They saw the situations, they heard the stories, and so they were willing to give their time and effort to create these programs. And they did. And then after we created it and then proved that it worked and then had all the data, then funding came. And then we got to have new positions that could do it. And then the faculty joined in and helped. And it cascaded from there until it was like a kind of a global departmental and college. The college has really supported us as well. But it really started with staff, who I think were the ones who were the closest to the students, to be honest, the ones who were advising them for hours whenever they were like in crises or, you know, struggling through data structures, through the Enigma machine project, trying to figure out what this thing does.
In our department that we have a lot of buy-in already. So the main way that we've done this is that many of our leadership folks are very committed to DEIA. So for example, right now, Magdalena Balazinska, who is our director, is actually very involved in our diversity, equity, inclusion, and access efforts. We also have an associate director who's a faculty member for DEIA and a staff director. So we have a number of positions that are just related to diversity, equity, inclusion, and access. What that allows us is sort of a top-down approach where we have people who are messaging from the top that we really need to make this commitment. So what's nice is that, again, we have buy-in from leadership, and then we actually have a lot of enthusiasm from faculty, students, and staff in creating an inclusive environment and a diverse environment. One challenge that we have found is that people want to get involved, but they don't necessarily know how to. So
the way that I got other people to join in to help change efforts, I have to say that we really have a lot of people that want to do a lot of good. But one way that I did do it for people that might have been a little bit more difficult to bring along in the process was reaching out for smaller things and building a relationship prior to the actual engagement or project that we want to work on.
You look at where your opportunities are. You start working with the people that are already wanting to work with you, who's interesting and willing to work on whether it be changes to pedagogy, changes to programming, that you're going to be doing more to improve student success. Because you're talking about a population of people that are doing a very important job. And they're also extremely busy, but many of them care and care deeply. And so again, finding the ones that do care, finding the ones that see that it's important to be more inclusive and more diverse as a discipline, and finding ways to recognize them.
When an effort depends on particular individuals and hasn't been made part of the system itself, then as soon as something happens to those individuals, the whole thing falls apart. We've been working on changing the way courses run. Pat Morreale is a longtime collaborator of mine on several NC WIT projects. And so she was aware of GenderMag and interested in it. And she's department chair. And she said, you know, we might be able to do this at my department. She asked her faculty, you know, would you be interested in doing this across our curriculum? And Kane University is primarily a teaching university, and faculty are rewarded for quality teaching and quality curriculum, and they were very interested in it. So some 2/3 of their faculty bought in and said, yeah, we want to try this out, and that was enough. So basically, she just laid it on the table, and it conformed to the reward system that university has set up. One of our researchers is an online instructor, She asked other people who she knows in the online program, you know, do you want to try this on your own online courses? She asked like 9 people she knew that thought, you know, that she thought, you know, they're always talking about inclusivity. I bet they would, you know, be interested in this. And I think something like 7 of them opted in.
I think that it takes a lot of conversation, like a lot of conversation. Like if you think that something is going weird in a course, right, you have to like be like, hey, I think something's going weird in your course. I heard this thing. And then they'll be like, oh, well, blah, 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 blah. And then you'll be like, oh, well, I wonder what they were talking about. So then there's like, da, da, da. but it's not all going to happen at once. And I think that in general, the thing that people look for is like drastic change, right? Like let's, I think that what's more likely and what's more doable in some sense is the change where like you slowly sort of shape shift over into something else, right? And so I think that a lot of conversation and a lot of patience is how you help people change to something that from what they knew to something that's more welcoming.
You know, it became just a conversation that was just normal. So when we would make decisions, when we would plan events, you know, we would always bring up, okay, what do we need to get more women here? What do we need to really keep women here? What is our curriculum doing that's either driving them away or, you know, keeping them from enrolling in the first place? So it wasn't hard. It was a department that really wanted it.
So there were a few things, confluence, is that the right term? A few things that came together that were carrots to encourage faculty to participate in broadening participation in computing. One of which is the National Science Foundation effort, where if you apply for a research proposal in some of their calls, such as their core calls, then you must have a BPC plan. Everybody. So that was a huge carrot to encourage faculty to look to see how they could make a positive impact for the community in the BPC space.